Welcome to this video lecture series on antenna and wave propagation. In this video, we'll discuss the next fundamental parameter, which is the radio communication link. In this, we'll discuss the Friss transmission formula. So we have discussed the radio communication link in my first video. So there I just discussed the overview about what a radio communication link is. Now in this video, we'll see the mathematical part of that radio communication link. So we'll start with the overview first and then we'll proceed to the mathematical discussion and then we'll see a numerical based on this mathematical discussion. So as I said in my previous video also that in radio communication link, I have a transmitter. I have a link between transmitter and transmitting antenna. So this line is called my link and then I have this transmitting antenna. So now this transmitting antenna will produce transverse electromagnetic wave. So these transverse electromagnetic wave would move a distance r where the receiving antenna is present. Now the receiving antenna is joined with the receiver with the help of receiving link. And then we have the receiver where I'll get my signals. So this is my radio communication link. Now I hope you got the overview about what is radio communication link. Now we'll see how mathematically I can derive the power at the receiving end if I have the power at the transmitting end. So in this equation, I am deriving the received power in relation to the transmitted power. So I know various factors like the frequency of the radiations, the distance between transmitter and receiver, the aperture area of transmitter, the aperture area of receiver, and the power transmitted by transmitter. Then after these things, I can find out the power received at the receiving terminal. So I know I have given the power transmitted at the transmitter. So PT represents time average radiated power by the transmitter. So time average radiated power by the transmitter. Now I know that the power density is represented by W average. So the power density is defined by time average radiated power divided by the area. So now if I am considering my transmitting antenna to be an isotropic antenna, so I am considering this to be an isotropic antenna. So where it would produce its radiation? It would produce its radiation in 360 degrees surrounding the transmitter. So if I have this radius r, it would produce the radiation with the radius r and 360 degrees surrounding it. So the total area in which it is producing its radiation is 4 pi r square. So the average power density would be given by transmitted power, which is given by PT of the transmitter divided by 4 pi r square. Now, as I said in my various previous videos that most of the transmitting antennas or any antenna are directional in nature. So, isotropic antenna is just an idealistic antenna. It does not exist practically. Practically, most of the antennas are directional in nature. So, when I have a directional antenna, its gain is coming into the picture. So it has more gain than the isotropic antenna. I hope you can understand. If I have isotropic antenna, it's all the radiations are distributed in the 360 degree. But when I have a directional antenna, here I have some radiation, but here I have maximum radiation. So I know that the gain of the directional antenna would be more than the gain of this isotropic antenna. So taking gain of the transmitting antenna to be GT,
so the average power density would come out to be PT GT upon 4 pi r square. So what is happening? I have the transmitter, which is a directional transmitter now. It is providing some power to the receiver. Now I know the average power density. Now at the receiving side, I know that the power received by the receiver is directly proportional to the aperture area of the receiver. So now if AR represents my aperture area of the receiver, now the power at the receiver would be average power density supplied by the transmitter multiplied by AR, which is the aperture area of the receiver. So what was my WAV? So PR would be, putting the value of WAV, PT GT upon 4 pi R square AR. Now I know that directivity is given by this formula, where directivity is equal to 4 pi upon lambda square into AT, where AT is the transmitting side aperture area. Now if I am considering my lossless conditions, where the receiver is lossless, so there is no loss happening. I know gain is equal to K into D, where K represents my radiation efficiency. So for lossless condition, so when the condition are lossless, K is equal to 1 and G is equal to D. So GT is equal to D is equal to 4 pi upon lambda square into AT. Now replacing this value of GT in equation number 1. So what would happen? Putting the value of GT in equation number 1, I get radiated power is equal to PT into 4 pi upon lambda square AT upon AR upon 4 pi R square. Now 4 pi and 4 pi got cancelled. Taking PT this side, PR upon PT is equal to AT AR upon lambda square R square. So now I got the received power, the transmitted power, the aperture area of transmitter, the aperture area of receiver, the wavelength of the transverse electromagnetic wave, and the distance between the transmitter and the receiver. So I get the relation between the received power and the transmitted power. If I have aperture area of both the antennas, the distance between the antennas, and the frequency or the wavelength of the transverse electromagnetic wave, and any one of the power, I can get the other power. So this is called my Friss transmission formula. So now I will solve a numerical based on this formula. So my question reads, a radio link has 15 watt transmitter connected to an antenna of 0.2 meter square, effective aperture of 0.5 meter square, and is located at a 15 kilometer line of sight distance from the transmitting antenna. Assume lossless mesh antennas. Find the power delivered to the receiver at 5 gigahertz. So now I know that the transmitted power is given, which is 15 watt. Now aperture area of transmitter is given, which is 0.2 meter square. Aperture area of receiver is given, which is 0.5 meter square. And after that, the distance between transmitting and receiving antenna, which is denoted by R. So here R denotes the distance between transmitting and receiving antenna, which is 15 kilometer, is equal to 15 into 10 raised to power 3 meters. So frequency is given, which is 5 gigahertz. Is equal to 5 into 10 raised to power 9 hertz. So I can find out lambda, which is C upon mu, is equal to 3 into 10 raised to power 8 upon 5 into 10 raised to power 9, because the value of C is 3 into 10 raised to power 8. Now it comes out to be 0.6 meter. Now I know the relation between received power and the transmitted power, which is equal to aperture area of receiver multiplied by aperture area of transmitter divided by R square lambda square. So now I know all of the values. So I need to find out the power delivered to the receiver. So I need to find out PR, which is equal to, so PT is 15, AR is 0.5, AT is 0.2 upon R is 15 into 10 raised to power 3 square into 0.6 square. So now putting all the values and finding the values, I would get the PR to be 1.66 into 10 raised to power minus 6 watts. So now this is how I can compute the received power or transmitted power if all the other parameters are given, that is aperture area of receiver, aperture area of transmitter, the distance between transmitter and receiver, that is R, and the frequency or the wavelength. So this relation is called the Friss transmission formula, and the overall system is called the radio communication link. So I'll stop at this point for this video. In the next video, I'll discuss the next fundamental parameter. I hope you like this video. Like this video, subscribe this channel, and stay tuned for the further videos. Thank you.